Relaxation. Sounds so relaxing, right? What is your perception of relaxation? For most of us, relaxation means to let go. Letting go of our tensions of the day, letting go of the responsibilities we bear on our minds temporarily, letting go of the physical pains and the muscle strains that we complain about day to day. But how do you practice it? Does sitting back on your favorite couch on a Sunday afternoon, watching your favorite movie, give you the ultimate relaxation? Hello and welcome. You are listening to one of India's top three podcasts on self-love and motivation, Women's Peria. I am Revati Desai. Hope and wish that you all are relaxed while or after listening to this podcast, because this podcast is your one-stop place for the daily dose of inspiration from people like you and me, listening to whom gives you hope and ideas on how to approach life on several aspects like emotional, inspirational, professional, and many more. Check out my other episodes for more. They say, take a vacation or relax your mind and soul. It's therapeutic. But for many, this metaphor doesn't actually work. We need actual therapy, which we don't realize until there is a nudge from the doctor. Such is the case with practicing yoga and many such precious habits. Today, our guests are Pooja and Ankit, who are aqua therapists and certified Vatsu, that is water plus shiatsu practitioners, and aqua yoga instructors from Mumbai. The idea of practicing yoga and getting therapy in water under controlled temperatures, going against the law of gravity, the thought itself sounds like floating amongst the clouds. This concept appeared pretty new to me, hence I pounced on the opportunity to know more about this and help our listeners also to get a fair idea and seek it when needed through this medium. Now let's get to know more from Pooja and Ankit. Hello and welcome to the podcast, Pooja and Ankit.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you both?
Doing very well, and I hope the same is true for you.
Yes, it is.
Happy to be here.
Wow. So I'm so excited. This is my first couples episode.
We are very excited as it is our first podcast ever.
Oh. I bet this will be a smooth experience for you both.
Let's hope.
Okay. So I'll try to be fair. I'll try to give the equal, undivided attention to you both.
No problem.
Okay. So, yes. So, once I begin, I start with the ice-breaking question. You both tell me. Probably you can divide it. I need the two affirmations that you say to your mirror every morning. One Pooja can tell me and another one Ankit can tell me.
Okay. My affirmation that I take every day in the mirror is that today is the day that I'm going to really listen to my body.
Mm-hmm.
And the other one is that I'm really going to be, I'm going to really find that quiet space for myself mm-hmm. at some point of time in the day to just reconnect.
Okay. Within your inner self?
To my inner self, yes.
Wow. Beautiful. Beautiful. What about Ankit?
I think I wake up a lot of days with this feeling that it's beautiful to be alive.
Oh.
Just to feel myself in this body, to breathe, to just be.
Yes.
I think that's just very beautiful and amazing in itself.
Yes, of course. That's beautiful. So just adoring the life that you've got and thanking God for that itself is a beautiful thing to do at the start of the day. Nice.
Okay. True.
Yes. Okay, so Pooja and Ankit, I just love learning about innovative and creative methods that we don't get to witness daily. I'm glad to know that I got to know you guys. So you guys tell me about how you guys met, your journey, like where did it all begin, and till you became aqua instructors. I guess this is a new concept in India, right?
It is pretty new worldwide,
okay.
And in India more so.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, about our journey, Ankit and I met through a common friend, interestingly, on 14th of Feb, Valentine's Day.
Wow.
Yes, that's quite a love story.
Ankit, you tell me about your first meeting with Pooja. Tell us about that.
It was a Sunday. It was the last day of the Kala Ghoda Art Festival in Mumbai in 2010.
Okay.
And like Pooja said, it was the 14th of February.
Wow, so much of detailing. Yeah, okay, yes.
Yeah. And we met in a beautiful Urdu storytelling session.
Ah, okay.
And we met through a common friend and we just clicked. And we clicked as friends. Hmm. And coincidentally, or call it synchronistically, she was working in a company very close to my place, you know, in Matunga.
Okay.
And she was like, oh, I found my Chinese food buddy, you know. So we met over chai. We had a lot of long walks, conversations. And we became friends first, you know.
Okay.
Very good friends. And we had a pretty good connection. And that same year, we traveled to Auroville.
Okay. Pondicherry.
And yeah, Auroville near Pondicherry.
Hmm.
And in fact, all my life, like until then, we were about 23 at that time.
Okay.
And I'd come to know about Auroville through a French couple that I'd met through couchsurfing.
Okay.
So I was amazed that, you know, having lived in India for so long, I didn't know that there was an international community where there were people from 50 countries around the world living and doing some very interesting experiments, experimenting alternative, you know.
Living together. Yeah.
So we traveled together. We lived there for a month.
Hmm.
And we came across some very interesting things there. One of the things being a program called Awareness Through the Body, which is, you know, mindfulness through various practices and activities and games. And so that journey that started in 2010 became, you know, a starting point for us. We kept coming back to Auroville later when we got married.
Hmm.
And we started immersing ourselves in various such practices that, you know, called out to us.
Mm-hmm.
And then in 2016, end of 2016, I came near Auroville to learn Thai yoga massage.
Okay.
And it was a month-long program.
Mm.
And then later, my teacher, who is quite a shaman, he asked me to continue, you know, for a couple more months.
Okay.
And he was teaching me many more things, including sound bath and energy healing and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then Pooja was here after finishing a project and she was like, what do I do now?
You
have your massage and everything. And that is how we came, we bumped into Vatsu, you know.
Okay.
And she was like, this looks interesting. Mm. Let me give it a shot.
Yes.
And she did one course and she was like, wow, this is great.
Mm-hmm.
And then she did another course and it was like, wow.
Mm-hmm.
And then she was unstoppable.
Oh.
And I was so inspired by her journey that the subsequent year, after I finished my training in massage, I started my journey.
Okay.
And yeah, I'll hand over to Pooja now so that she can tell you about her journey.
Yes, sure. Then we progress to the next question. Like, how did you find Vatsu, or Vatsu found you? How was it? Yes.
So how Vatsu found me is something that Ankit responded to. The interesting thing that I would like to talk about is that a couple of years after our marriage, Ankit was severely ill, because we, you know, at that point, after we decided to get married, and we did get married, we went through what most of us go through, and that is like picking up a house, having jobs, like both of us were working in the corporate world. It was a 9-to-5 job that we were working in, a really high stress kind of a situation where you're working for long hours and you have only weekends, and those weekends are generally dedicated to your friends, your family.
Yes.
With very, very little space and time left for yourself.
Correct.
And it was during one of these really stressful times that Ankit was going through. And like he said, that we did something called as couch surfing. So couch surfing is where someone from, people from around the world are on this platform called couch surfing.
Okay.
And you are welcome to, people's houses on this platform. So like people from China, from France, from all over the world have came and stayed with us.
Okay.
In our apartment in Borivali.
Okay.
And the exchange is just that, you know, they tell you about their stories and their lives and, you know, you get to meet interesting people.
Mm-hmm.
And that's about it. So there's no money or anything involved in this. This is just, you know, how you meet people.
Okay.
And one of our very close friends, Publio from Brazil, is how we met through this. And Ankit took ill very seriously at this point in our life journey. And he actually decided to go to Brazil, leave his job, his 9-to-5 job, and go and travel to Brazil for 3 months, which he did. Eventually.
Okay.
And luckily, because his boss used to really like him, they let him be a part of the company. So he has been actually working from home for a long time now.
Oh, okay.
The concept is not new to us.
Okay.
And once he came back, we decided to adopt this as a lifestyle. So after that, even I left my job and the two of us traveled to Indonesia for 3 months.
Okay.
And till then, I was always extremely afraid of water. But I didn't know how to swim. So I had no idea because as a kid, we were never really taught how to swim in our schools, or we didn't really have access to swimming pools.
Yeah.
And as an adult, I drowned twice because apparently the way they teach in India is to push you in the deep end of the pool and hope that you survive it.
Yes.
And the trauma that creates is amazing.
Yes.
So I was really, really afraid. And we were staying in Bali and we met this Australian guy who was wonderful.
Okay.
And he's the one who actually took me in water and actually was my first teacher in water, in swimming. And I remember getting into water and telling him that I'm really afraid of it.
Okay.
And he looked at me and he said that you should be. It's a powerful element. You should respect it. And, you know, just the moment he accepted my fear, I was able to let it go.
Wow. Yes.
And that was so beautiful that, you know, to just accept the fact that you're afraid of something. And if someone really accepts it, that yes, you know, this is true. It's a powerful element that you should respect it.
Okay.
And that is how my journey with water really started. And in 2016, when Ankit was doing his massage, and when I was again asking him that, okay, you're doing a massage, what exactly am I supposed to do? And we were just figuring out, and he was like, you know, you just recently learned how to, you know, swim and everything. Why don't you give Vatsu a try?
Okay.
And I swear to God, my first session with Daniel, I felt like a fish in the ocean. I will never forget that feeling.
Oh, okay.
And that's a wonderful feeling for someone who has been so afraid of water for so long. That it can really have a very deep impact on you. And I remember coming out of the pool and I was like, you know, maybe I should give this a try.
Okay.
And that is how my journey with Vatsu started.
Vatsu started. Beautiful.
So I was actually a hydrophobic.
Oh, yes. So so really, I mean, the journey that you two have traveled has been, I would say, the first word that comes to my mind is quite bold. Because making such bold decisions that you have done in life, like leaving your corporate jobs for something that you love to do, and coming out of your fear of towards water, that is hydrophobia. That is, I mean, if you ask me, any person would never ever do that. And this is really commendable. And you were talking about couch surfing. All these things are really a new concept to me. So I'm learning pretty new things and wonderful things from you. And not only learning about these concepts, but to observe them and change your lifestyle, which is actually inspiring many more. Kudos to you guys. Okay, so moving to the next question, Pooja, can you elaborate to the listeners that what exactly Vastu is? What Shiatsu is? We know what is water. What is Shiatsu?
Yes. So Shiatsu is basically, so think of it like this. In ancient times, the Nadi system of our, so you know Nadi system.
Yes, yes.
Right? So Nadi system of India went to China. And that was then called meridians and acupressure and acupuncture. And this modality then traveled to Japan and was adapted into Shiatsu. So Shiatsu is basically working with the meridians, and meridians are basically your Nadi system.
Okay.
So it is actually working with the Nadi system in water. So we Zen Shiatsu, specifically from where Vatsu is coming from, is working. So if you see acupressure or all these things, you work with massaging the points, right?
Yes.
That is something that we do as well. But we also believe that if you stretch the body in certain ways, the entire meridian of that side gets stretched. So Vatsu will involve. Typically, a Vatsu session will involve a lot of stretching, a lot of massage, a lot of flow work. So this is where water plus Shiatsu is coming from. That is Vatsu.
Okay.
Now, also medically speaking, because you're not fighting gravity in water, your spine has that chance to completely relax.
Okay.
Because this is the only time it has, really, where it can completely release itself. Otherwise, you know, you're always fighting gravity, even when you're sleeping, you're standing, you're sitting, anything that you're doing.
Right.
So water is the only way that it can release. Vatsu, we do it in warm water. And in 20 minutes in warm water, your muscles completely relax.
Okay.
So your muscles are relaxing, your spine is relaxing, we are stretching you, we are massaging you, and we are breathing with you.
Okay. So
That is how, you know, we are creating this environment for you to completely go deeply within yourself, to really, really listen to your heartbeat, listen to yourself, listen to your body. And that is the crux of Vatsu, that it creates that environment, that situation where you can really listen to your body.
I'll be frank, this sounds really complicated to me, because for all these years, I'm just believing, like, once you get into the water, you have no sense. I mean, you're telling me that you feel the pressure points and you give them the proper treatment. What is the exact term for that? Is it like you massage them, right?
Yes, so, they massage them.
Yes. So I never knew that one can feel these pressure points within water, once you're inside water. So,
you feel, and you feel them so wonderfully.
Really, really. Okay.
Yes, and Ankit gives amazing massage, by the way.
Yes, probably Ankit can tell about the massaging things that he's, and the other practices that he's doing with the clients.
Yeah, so I love the fact about Vatsu that one is, you're in water, it's actually a kind of meditation in water, where you're holding a person, you're syncing your breath with their breath, and this is where I could also use all the massage techniques that I learned from my Thai yoga massage course.
Okay.
So I incorporate a lot of that. There's a lot of free flow. So it's not a rigid technique where you have a very rigid structure of, you know, how to proceed, because everybody is very different. Every person you meet in water, you know, there are people who come with a lot of fear of water, a lot of tension in their bodies. They float very differently. They have different flexibilities. So every time you meet a new person, and even if you, when you meet the same person again in water, it's always different. So it's about being present, being there, and seeing what the body wants.
Okay.
And that is how we approach it.
Yes.
And it's not as complicated as it may sound. And it would be very interesting for everybody to know that we have all received a Vatsu session in our life.
Mm-hmm.
It was the first thing that we received in our life before we were born. Because in our mother's womb, we were in a fluid environment.
Yes.
Our greatest development, our most exponential growth before we are born happens in a fluid environment, which is a very warm, very nurturing environment. That is where your entire body, mind develops.
Correct.
And Vatsu is actually reconnecting with that nurturing space, going back to becoming a baby. You know, in our day-to-day lives, we are constantly fighting, struggling for survival. You know, once you're out of your mother's womb, you're out there on your own.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
In life, you're taught to take care of yourself, to survive physically, mentally, financially, socially, in every way. So, a lot of life is struggle, dealing with stress, dealing with challenges, competition, all of that. But Vatsu is like going back to that pre-birth state of being in your mother's womb, where you're just held, where you're not fighting anything, where you're just being cared for and nurtured in a very safe environment, which is very similar to the kind you experienced in your mother's womb, you know, warm water, warm fluid environment, a very caring person holding you.
Correct.
And breathing with you.
Yeah. The way Ankit described, I mean, I felt myself again being in my mother's womb and the safe environment that we would get into once I get a Vatsu treatment. I mean, a Vatsu session with you guys. Yes. So what kind of audience? I mean, who actually needs this? Is it like anybody can go for it? Or do you have, does the therapy work for all ailments?
So in general, I mean, anybody who needs to relax, and I don't know anybody other than the Buddha. I think even the Buddha would need, I mean, you know, massage developed at the time of the Buddha. And even somebody who is a monk would need something to relax.
Okay.
So this is very universal. It doesn't necessarily have to be somebody who is, you know, having a very serious ailment, physical, mental, to you know, it's like self-care, right? You're relaxing yourself, you're taking care of your body, your mind. So you don't need to come with a certain kind of, you know, physical or mental ailment. But it can be helpful for anybody who wants to just de-stress, relax, or find, you know, come in a space where you feel more connected with yourself, you know, to come in a more meditative, this is like accelerated meditation.
Okay.
You know, a lot of people try to meditate, they struggle because it's difficult, you know, it's difficult to sit really concentrate and calm your mind, right?
Yes.
So what happens, so when you're sitting, you're trying to sit straight, right? So like Pooja said, you're fighting gravity. So to hold your body, you're using a lot of energy. Then to calm your mind, to center your mind, you're using a lot of energy. So willpower gets depleted very quickly. As against, now, if you're in water, you know, your fight with gravity drops very significantly. You're automatically, you know, getting in a very calm environment. So it's like leapfrogging the entire process of coming to a space where you can easily relax and meditate.
Yes. Okay.
Besides, I think Pooja can throw light on the kind of rehab cases. A lot of people with very different ailments who come and who find, you know, relief from Vatsu.
Yes, please. Yeah.
Like Ankit said, you know, Vatsu is for anyone and everyone. And there are no age barriers as well for this.
Okay.
We have had the opportunity to give it to like a 3-month baby as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I have given it to 71-year-old Nimmi auntie,
mm-hmm.
the famous video
mm-hmm.
on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
So age is really no barrier for this.
Mm.
As far as ailments are concerned, so this is brilliant for anyone who has any kind of back issues.
Okay. Okay.
Specifically, I'm specifying that because in Vatsu, we work a lot with the spine, with the releasing of the spine, with the freeing of the spine.
Mm-hmm.
And your spine really, you know, your lower back, your upper back and, you know, everything in between
mm-hmm.
sort of is responsible for your posture, for fighting the gravity all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So at some point of time, we are all, you know, have been getting backaches and all mm-hmm. of this. So it's a very common ailment
mm-hmm.
and with age more so.
Hmm.
So anyone with back issues, this is absolutely brilliant for them.
Okay.
To do and relax.
Hmm.
I get a lot of people who are hypertension. For anyone who has hypertension,
yes,
this is brilliant
hmm.
because this really calms your mind
hmm.
down. It
hmm.
activates. So in Vatsu, what happens is your parasympathetic nervous system gets activated.
Okay.
So we have two nervous system in our body.
Hmm.
One is sympathetic nervous system that
yes.
is responsible for your flight and fight,
hmm.
for your survival, for hmm. you know, for your survival thing.
Hmm.
So everything that you're doing right now
hmm.
is in that zone.
Hmm.
Your parasympathetic nervous system is the nervous system that is taking care of your rejuvenation, your regeneration, your relaxation, and all of this.
Okay.
For most people, this gets activated only when we are sleeping.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Generally, this is a nervous system that we do not activate so much, especially in these times that we are in,
mm-hmm.
where we are constantly working and constantly on our phones and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Our parasympathetic nervous system is not getting as activated or as it should.
Okay.
And Vatsu is one way in which we activate your parasympathetic nervous system
mm-hmm.
that helps you to really relax.
Hmm.
And really rejuvenate.
Okay.
So so that really helps, you know, with a lot of anxiety, hypertension,
hmm.
a lot of these issues.
Hmm.
They sort of, you know, you can really work with them.
Okay.
People with fibromyalgia, a lot
hmm.
of these cases also
hmm.
come to me.
Okay.
And it works brilliantly for them as well.
Hmm.
So actually we have an a range.
Hmm.
of medical you know conditions
okay.
that we work with
hmm.
and that's specifically called something called as rehab Vatsu
okay. okay
or medical Vatsu
hmm.
and that is so a lot of people you know with stroke
hmm.
Paralysis
hmm.
a lot of these issues they come and we work with them
okay
and it really helps them it really 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 helps them.
That was exactly my question because for people with birth defects, muscular defects,
yes.
muscular dystrophy and conditions.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes,
so,
muscular dystrophy, it's really good for people with muscular dystrophy.
Hmm. Okay. And also, as you said, it activates the parasympathetic sympathetic nerves. So people
yeah.
who are having issues with their nerves, like they're spastic and
yes,
for them, it works wonders, right?
Yes, it does. Of course, before taking up a case like this, we see
mm-hmm.
the medical history.
Mm-hmm.
And because currently in Mumbai, we are working
mm-hmm.
in, you know, clinics per se.
Okay.
In the sense that both the places that I work in
mm-hmm.
are, their doctors sit out of those places.
Okay.
So
okay.
we actually do an entire medical checkup
okay.
before we take these cases in. So we are very, very careful because, you know, while it sounds absolutely amazing and everything,
mm-hmm.
there are certain counterindications to this,
mm-hmm.
like for most things in life.
Okay.
So we have to also know. So, you know, this is also another thing that
mm-hmm.
A lot of people do maybe just, you know, the basic course of Vatsu and, you
mm-hmm.
know, are, you know, sort of doing
Hmm.
and applying this and sort of asking people to come in the water.
Hmm.
And it amazes me that, you know, what people don't realize is that water is very, very calming and wonderful and beautiful element, but it's a very, very powerful element.
Of course.
Your metabolism, for example, goes 10x in water.
Mm.
So if there is someone who is diabetic, for example,
mm-hmm.
and if he gets into water without eating anything or eating his medicines, then it is an issue.
Mm-hmm.
Like for someone who has a heart issue or has very cold veins, we need to be careful about the temperature of the water.
Okay.
So these are things that also one needs to learn and one needs to be aware of.
Aware of, exactly.
Yeah, before, you just jump in the water and you are ready to relax, we also need to be careful about how we are going about it.
Right.
And luckily with us, we have studied it, and also we work with doctors, so we are very, very careful and very, very we do our due diligence before we take someone in.
Of course. So any person who comes in for a therapy session with you, not only should he be frank with his medical history, but he should open up to you about any special conditions that he has, so that later he doesn't cause any problem to you.
Absolutely.
And for himself as well.
Absolutely. Yes. And it's amazing. It's just amazing, Revati, how many people we meet who mid-session will tell me, oh, by the way, maybe I think I should just tell you that, I have asthma.
And
I'm like, well, okay. Oh, sorry, but you know what? Do you need to know that I also have diabetes? Yes, I do.
Yes.
So it's interesting that, these things happen, because I think, especially in India, we are not the due diligence isn't such a
very responsible about our medical conditions, right? So, disclosing it to someone is actually a prestige issue.
Yes, and it's interesting that, this happens quite a few times.
Okay.
And that is the thing, that even if it happens, we know how to handle it.
Beautiful.
Because we have had enough cases like these, and this is something that actually our teachers also teach us, that if something like this happens, you know how to handle the situation.
So, okay, so you guys are more or less like healers, right? So I've, all these years I've seen that healers, when they try to heal someone, when they are giving somebody a therapy, they take the pain and the sense of that person into themselves, right? So after a session, after a day session, how do you guys feel? How does Ankit and Pooja feel? Because you said you sync your breath with your clients, and you've made them relax. So since they're relaxing, the entire their burden, I guess it falls upon you. So how do you feel after a session? After giving a session? Yes.
This is amazing, because I want to really talk about this. First of all, Ankit and I, especially us, I don't know about anyone else, but the two of us, we really stay away from the word healer.
Okay.
The thing is that we are in the space of healing, but not necessarily the fact that we are healers. I think it's the water. So one of the things that our teachers, luckily, and also, you need to be self-aware enough to know this, sort of focus on is that it is the water that is doing the magic.
Yes.
And of course, the two of us are there, and we need to keep our energies clear. And I will talk about how we keep our energies clear.
Right.
But as far as taking somebody's grief or any of, their problems or anything like that, the beauty of this work is that this is done in water. And water is the one that is taking all of it. So nothing is coming to me. That is why the flow of it is so important, because it is in the flow that everything, is going.
Okay.
And so the two of us, sure, you get, after you've given a couple of sessions, you get tired and everything. And, you sort of have to maintain a certain lifestyle to be able to do this work. So, you need to be very, very self-aware about your own mental state.
Okay.
So I cannot relax anyone unless I'm relaxed.
Yes.
And this is a mantra that sort of we follow. So, and, you know, both of us relax in different ways. I relax by reading a book, talking to my friends, being with my family, and having my own time. Ankit relaxes by, you know, singing, his music. He has different things that he does. He'll talk about that. And I think what the two of us mostly do is we take care of ourselves.
Yes. And don't bother each other.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the most important thing, that we don't bother each other.
Okay. Absolutely.
And the clients, we don't really, we don't take their stories with us home.
Oh, okay. Right.
Yeah, it is their story, and it is for them to live, and we are just giving them the environment where they can heal. If they heal, that's absolutely amazing, and if they cannot, maybe something else will work for them.
Beautiful. Okay.
So Revati, I'll add a couple points to your question.
Please, yes.
So while we try to be facilitators, then healers, you know, and let water do the magic. It is not possible to cut off from the person who is there with you, right?
Correct.
So if they come with a lot of grief or with a lot of stress, and be it in water as therapists or even when you're just meeting people in general, there is always an energy exchange.
Correct. Yes.
It's going to rub off, you know, with you in some way or the other. What we try to do is we try to be conscious about it and to be very careful in how we take care of ourselves. That's, I think, very essential that, like Pooja said, we are not here to heal people. We are not, we would love to facilitate the healing, but we can help people relax only if we are relaxed in the first place.
Very
so
true.
our focus and our life journey is to relax.
Correct.
And if we relax, then, you know, the environment around us will automatically get that vibe and, you know, they may benefit from it.
That is beautiful. So what I derive is you act like the medium where people get relaxed and water is actually, which is taking care of everything, which is actually providing the therapy to your clients.
Yes.
But you are the proper medium through which they can connect with water.
Facilitators, maybe. Medium again.
In the same
words.
Word.
Dangerous.
Oh, yes.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, nice. Okay, energy transfer does happen. The vibes that you carry, it does matter a lot.
It does happen, yes. I will agree with Ankit too on that it does happen in the sense it can happen. The idea is that it can happen.
Yes.
But again, the thing is that when you're really connecting with people and, you know, we do something called as water breath dance where we are syncing our breath with the person. And yes, you feel that, you know, this person is releasing something. And that is exactly what you need to learn. Right. That it is the person releasing. And it's his story.
Correct.
And his life.
Yes.
And you are just there as a witness.
Yes. Exactly. Witness is the word. Exactly. Yes.
Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You don't get involved in the stories. You don't get on a mission to heal them and solve all their life problems. You know, the aim is to always empower the person so that they can take care of themselves and lead a more a life that is more self-aware, more conscious, where they learn to take care of themselves. The idea is not to create dependency.
Correct. Yes. Okay. So it was a lovely session talking to you guys. You guys tell me now, so what are your future plans with this? So how is this going to work in India? Right now, where is Vatsu available? It's only available in Mumbai or where is?
And in Mumbai, in Pondicherry, Quiet Healing Center.
Okay.
We feel that people connect with this kind of therapy.
Hmm.
And the only thing that is needed is a temperature controlled pool. So wherever there will be temperature controlled pools, we are happy to go there and offer Vatsu session. And we are also developing other kind of relaxation techniques, like I mentioned in the beginning, that we pursued programs like awareness through the body.
Yeah.
I also learned some massage techniques, sound bath meditation. So we are also in the process of developing various modalities on in water, on land, that where people can relax. That is ultimate goal. That is the ultimate goal for
us,
to help people relax. And there are always infinite ways in which it can be done.
I would like to take this opportunity and tell people that Vatsu and Aqua Yoga are two different things. Because there seems to be aqua therapy under which everything comes. And because these are such new things and new terminologies that people are sort of also getting confused. Aqua yoga is bringing the modality of Hatha yoga in water. And this is a proper yoga session that we do. Where we are working out in the water. And this is also done for a lot of rehab work and generally for from weight loss to just, you know, generally relaxing your muscles, flexibility, balance and core strength. So, you know, we have an entire spectrum on which we work with aqua yoga also. And but this is a different modality altogether from Vatsu. So, you know, just for your listeners and anyone who's going to be listening to this, these are two very, very different things. Yeah, so these are pretty regular people that come to me and generally also. So, I also work a lot with, you know, people who have osteoporosis or, you know, arthritis. A lot of these conditions. And aqua yoga is brilliant with, you know, all of these conditions. For people who have injuries and cannot work on land, can start their work in water and then go on to land. For people who have who want to also, because we work a lot on pranayama and a lot of meditation and things like these also, it's quite a mix that, that I do. So, you know, I have people coming from weight loss, to improve their flexibility and core strength, to people to improve their balance and to work with their muscles that aren't functioning as they should on land, to everything else, you know. And this is a workout session that we do in water. In Vatsu is passive, where you're lying on your back with your eyes closed, and it is the therapist that is doing all the moving around and stretching and everything else. In aqua yoga, your eyes are open, you're standing or squatting in water, and you're doing the workout with me.
So throughout my life, I have had great affinity towards water. Just like me, everybody would be having the same mindset. So I guess people would love enjoying doing and exercising in water, rather than doing it on land.
It is, it's more fun.
So it was great getting to know you and learning from you about the concept of Vatsu and aqua yoga. So all the best to you guys. May you learn more, may you grow more, and may your services help many, many more people around.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Revati. It was lovely talking to you.
Same here.
Really nice talking to you.
Wow, thank you very much. Thank you very much, Pooja, and thank you very much, Ankit, for being here in my podcast.
Thank you.
And sharing such great insights with my listeners and my and me.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Pooja and Ankit are the perfect examples of what couple goals are. We also got to learn from them more about aqua therapy, aqua yoga, and Vatsu. I wish them more success and luck so that they can reach to more people. To let us know how you felt about today's episode, you can send me an email at womenspedia@gmail.com. And if you want your story to be featured, you can send me an email in the same. The spelling goes by WOMINSPIRIA@gmail.com. Womenspedia pages can be found in LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube and Instagram. There is also a Womenspedia Tamil podcast where you can listen to Tamil inspirational stories. Apart from that, I have a podcast in which I record and converse a lot with my son about everything that he questions about. And that podcast can be found in all podcast platforms. It's called Shashu and Amma. So until next time, keep faith, keep inspiring, and find inspiration everywhere around you. This is Revati signing off from Womenspedia, contagiously inspiring. Thank you very much.